Hey guys, so this is my fourth work in progress video. We left off last video with the right leg, and I noticed that some of the panel lines on here are really thin. Off camera, I actually did go in and I tried to accentuate this a little bit. I might just cut out a piece of plot plate, and I also notice that there's no line here, and I think I'm either going to glue the parts together or make a line, panel line there. It's just going to be difficult to do, but I could put the plot plate over that. And there's also this circle line that I wanted to accentuate, but I don't have the tools to do that, so I just went and ordered a scriber, and hopefully I should have that in a few days, because right now I've just been using the back of my hobby knife to do straight lines, which it works just fine. Don't really need a special tool for that. So let's get started on the second leg. So we already have basically the foot and the upper thigh built from last episode. So we need this F runner again. Gonna be pulling a lot of parts off of there. Where did I put my file? That's interesting. There it is. Oops. Thank you. Yeah, the only thing about this part is it's got that seam line on it. I might try a different file for this. If I can find where I put the file set. Let's see. I think there's a... Yeah, there's these rectangular ones. Not sure what the difference is. This may be better for getting this little line here. Yeah, that seems to be a bit better. Still got a little bit in there, but it's not as bad. Same thing on this side. It's got that seam line. Yeah, sorry about my my camera setup. It's a work in progress. I'm still waiting on my tax return, and then once I get that, hopefully I'll get a new camera and probably change the position of where I have it. That looks acceptable. And there we go. The next part is where we have a bunch of polycaps put in. Actually, I'm going to reference this part. Doesn't look like any of that really shows through, so I'm just going to cut it off. I really like all the detail in this inner frame, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna paint any of it. I probably won't. One more. We need so with this kit, we do kind of have an inner frame going, but it's not really anything too detailed. The arms don't have an inner frame. They really don't. They have like an upper inner frame, but the bottom part is just like three pieces that fit together. We get the link and this goes here and this. There, like that. And yeah, that's the opposite of it. Now we just need to put a screw in there. And I need my screwdriver. And by the way, let me take this armor off real quick, just if I can even get it off. Huh. Jeesh. It's on there pretty good. So, this is basically the, that's a rough fit. That's the inner frame for the leg. So, there's that. I mean, obviously there's a ton of mechanical detail down here, but you don't, all you really see are these little vents right here. And, yeah, nothing really going on at the top. I'm sure detail was an afterthought on this kit. They were probably more concerned about the transformation working correctly. Now we need some more parts from the F-runner. So usually when I detail a kit, I go back in after it's all built. That's why I'm kind of just leaving alone the these like panel lines. I don't really rescribe that one, but you can just see like the difference it makes compared to the thin ones. This one's kind of rough, but they always look like rough when you first start out. Once you get it going a little bit more, it'll look a lot cleaner. Plus you have to, oops, hit it from both sides too, not just one side. See, looks a little better. Plus it's got gunk and stuff in it, so once you clean it out, it'll look better. Anyway, on to these parts. I really like this design though. They designed this suit really nicely. It's from Gundam Sentinel, which I actually haven't read because I think it's a novel. So I'll have to get around to it sometime. Because, oh man, I really roughed up that part. It's a popular series, even though Gundam hasn't, Bandai hasn't made a ton of kits from it or anything. There we go. That's better. Just need to... hit this edge. It's acceptable. It's not as nice as I'd like it to be. Definitely not, but I think it's because of these lines. Yeah. Oops, I thought it was done. I want to say, yeah, you don't really see the edges of this part, so we shall cut. Yeah, it's definitely not worth sanding and messing up the part if I can just cut it off. And that goes here. This. And I think that should be it for that. Let's need this. I just noticed for the little Amuro figure, he has no base. I've never seen a figure like that that has no base on the feet. Well, I guess it's easily fixable, but, you just make a little base for him, but that's really interesting. No base for the feet. Boop. I always like that they include the to scale figures so you know what it would look like in real life, basically. These parts. I also appreciate that they make these parts separate, because I might want to paint those black, maybe? Maybe black. Ooh, man, that's a rough seam line there. Good thing it's on the inside, though. These, I don't think you're actually going to see these. They're up in the, they're going to be under the armor. So it's always good when Bandai thinks it through and puts numb marks in places where they're not going to get in the way. Or be visible, I should say. They'll get in the way if you don't cut them off. That was one of the issues I had when I was a lot younger. I built Zoid model kits, and obviously I was like 8 years old or something, so I didn't put too much effort into those. Sorry, I got a little distracted. Okay, I see what's going on there. I would just get like a pair of nail clippers. I would clip off the parts from the runner, and then I would put it together. That would be it. So then there would be some parts where I had trouble getting it together. I'm like, oh, why am I having trouble getting this together? Well, it's because there was a huge gaping nub mark that I didn't sand off. Or cut off or anything. Oops. Totally forgot about that. It says it's on the E-runner. Is that not the E-runner? Is this not? No. It must be on the other E-runner. There it is. We need... this. And this goes on to here, like that, and this can come off. Still gotta be kind of careful, but not too careful. Fit it under there. No, it looks not. If I pull that out a little bit, should be able to squeeze that. down in there. There we go. And then the orange part. Again, I've said this before, but I really love the color of orange that they put in this plastic. Now, I've been thinking about how I want to paint this kit. It's technically test colors, I think that's what it's called. So it's not like the true zeta-plus colors, which is this, just the zeta-plus test colors. And I was almost thinking of doing like the caution, like yellow and black striped kind of look on some parts. But then I kind of wanted to do like digital camo. But that doesn't make too much sense. Why would you have camo on like a test suit? But then again, I don't really have to paint it the test colors. I could paint it whatever I wanted. And finally, we have this part. There is leg number two. So now we have our two legs. I like that. You got the almost like a light tan on the front and the orange on the back. I almost want to do like a complete separation and just paint like there would be different shades, like maybe that would be like a dark orange. And then some like orange here. Now it has us build the head. So it wants us to do the head. But I know the side skirts attach to the side of the legs. So I think we're gonna build the side skirts, which are a lot more complex than I thought they would be. But I'd like to attach them to the legs. So, first, take the rest of our F-runner, or not the rest, but mostly the rest. Cut off these two parts. And I think I'm actually going to cut off these nub marks since they're in kind of hard to reach places. Yeah, and this one isn't exactly flush against the part. Got like a little bit here. And then there's like a little being really careful not to mess this up. Okay. And now we need. Oops. We need a 15. This G. We also need 2 and 12. Sorry about that. I had a bug flying around in my room. We need 23. Did I already cut that out? I did. Okay. Then we need a 16. I-16. Now, these are pretty complex side skirts for a kit. Usually they don't get this complex. I always hate these parts. I'm never too sure about how to go about cutting the nub marks off, because I always seem to leave like a flat surface on them, even if I sand or whatever. So I just do the best I can to cut them as flat as I can, or as round as I can, I should say. Pretty round to me. Ready. So I have to get this. Were there really only two numb marks on this? I could have swore there was a third one. Ah, there it is. All right. Believe everything's in the correct spot. And like I said, these are pretty complex. Got this, plug that to there. And got this, which goes. Nope, everything isn't in the right place. There we go. And finally, this plugs onto there. So I'm not sure why this part moves, but it does. So there's one. And now for the other. There isn't a part on there. I'm just pulling random runners at this point. I really am. So if I need this. There's a part I just saw on this runner that I forgot to put in earlier. So I think I'll go back real quick and put that back in. And believe that's all the parts. And then I'm missing this part. I forgot to put this in. Believe it was the other link I just built. And goes right here. There we go. Thankfully, it wasn't too bad of a mess up. Could have been a lot worse. Alright, now onto this. I think I'm just gonna cut these all with a hobby knife. Now, this is the only master grade I've noticed so far that I've ever built that the instructions follow as like a high grade kit. They're not really like in individual sections or labeled or anything like that. It's just kind of interesting. And most kits, they don't have you build like arms, then legs, then the head, then the body. Usually it's the opposite, they'll have you build like the body first. Alrighty. And now we just have to attach them. So it looks like we use some H parts. That's interesting. These parts don't really hold together or anything. I guess they kind of do. It's not the kind of holding together. They just have very tiny pegs. I almost want to glue these. Now, oh, I almost forgot one thing. We have beam sabers. See, I had the plan to keep all the runners on that runner shelf, but currently there are exactly zero runners on my runner shelf. It's not that great, really. And I hear another bug in my room. It looks like beam saber fits down like that. Finally, we get our little I say to make sure that's facing the bottom. That goes in there. And then, oops, that was the right leg. This goes on here, and this goes here. And there we go. Those are the side skirts. First Gundam I've seen where it attaches to the legs like that. But next episode, we will begin work on the head. Thanks for watching. If you can think of any ways that I can improve these videos, please leave a comment and let me know. Thanks again.